A smoke signal? Thoughts, Yogini?
In former times, such signals were used to announce the coming of an emissary of peace. In Doma, at least. But could that truly be their intent?
Who can say? Whatever they want, we cannot simply blast them out of the sky. Not when they were so gracious as to honor one of our cherished traditions. I would not have it said that we Dormans want for propriety.
Then I shall go and reconnoiter.
Nay, that won't be necessary. We will meet them openly. I would welcome this student of Dorman history in person, whomsoever he or she may be.
As you wish, my lord. I shall arrange for a signal of our own to be fired in answer.
Should be received by the Lord of Doma himself.
I but afford an emissary of peace the courtesy he is due. Welcome to Doma, my lord.
Ah, where are my manners? I am Asahi Sus Brutus, ambassador plenipotentiary of Garlemont.
He is heir to the Naiuri clan and Yotsu's stepbrother.
It seems I need not introduce myself, not in the presence of the famed Yugiri Mistwalker. Your skills as a shinobi are known far and wide, my lady. It is true, the former acting viceroy is my sister. Yet, bonds of kinship aside, we have precious little in common. As will soon become plain, I come not to sow strife, but to end it. I am of the Populares, a collective which represents the interests of the common man. Long have we labored to bring about reform to the Empire's provincial policy. Happily for us, our master acknowledges the need for change. Indeed, his radiance, Emperor Varys Zos Galvus, personally sanctioned this mission, granting me the authority to speak with his voice. To negotiate peace with Doma.
Well then, we have much to discuss. Will you accompany me to my hall?
Gladly, my lord. On behalf of my delegation, I offer you my humblest thanks. Never did I imagine that I would meet the gallant and noble Lord of Dorma himself, nor be welcomed into his magnificent hall.
You'll forgive me if we forgo the pleasantries. You say you are come to negotiate peace. Unless I am mistaken, such negotiations are typically conducted between sovereign nations. I was not aware that the Emperor had recognized Dorma's sovereignty.
His Radiance has yet to do so, that much is true. Know, however, that he has expressed willingness to cede Dorma to her ancestral masters and treat with her as a friend. Since the days of Emperor Solus, the Empire has aggressively expanded its territory. While you may not agree with our Founding Father's policy of expansion, I believe there is room for discussion on the matter of his lifelong goal, to rid the world of icons. Icons are a blight upon this star. They cannot be suffered to exist. This you know as well as we. In his wisdom, Emperor Varus wishes to explore the possibility of an alliance to combat this common threat. On the condition that Dorma renounces summoning and pledges to police the Cordian's practice of it, his Radiance would extend the hand of friendship.
Dorma has never shown any appetite for summoning, and it should go without saying that we will address any threat to our people, icon or otherwise. With regard to the Cordian, I must stress that they only resorted to summoning under extreme provocation. When the Ruby Sea was at peace and their sacred relics safe, they looked not to their karma for protection. Yet even now there are certain parties who would destabilize the region with ill-conceived military forays. Unless they alter their course, we cannot hope to be rid of icons.
Quite. I can but apologize. In seeking to eliminate icons, the Empire creates them. Tis an irony among ironies, one with which the people of Eorzea are well acquainted, I am told.
Indeed, many summonings are the result of persecution, the weak being driven to call upon the divine for deliverance from the strong. So it was in Alamigo, the bitter fruit of Garlean oppression.
A tragic state of affairs. If we are to put an end to summoning once and for all, it shall not be through might, but harmony. Yet we continue to repeat our mistakes, oblivious to the lessons of history. My comrades and I would change all that. We Populares have campaigned long and hard for a shift in imperial policy. And at last, the Emperor has seen fit to lend us an ear. Alas, there is a faction within Garlemald that would obstruct our every attempt at reform. A collection of pure-blooded Garleans who seek to consolidate their own supremacy. The Optimates. Lest you wonder, theirs was the hand that loosed our forces on the Confederacy. 'Twas a regrettable incident, one that flies in the face of everything we believe. And I swear to do all in my power to prevent a reoccurrence.
That would be most welcome. But if I may speak plain, if the Empire itself is not of one mind, how can we be certain that any peace we negotiate will be honored?
I cannot blame you for doubting us. Indeed, I should find it strange if you did not. And so, in the name of building trust, I would like to make a proposal. A prisoner exchange. Under Garlean rule, no few Dormans were conscripted into the Imperial Army. We would repatriate them in return for those of ours you captured in the recent conflict. Naturally, any exchange would include the acting viceroy.
Yotsuba? What makes you think we have her?
Forgive me, my lord. Was it not your wish to speak plain? Let us not play games. I desire only to work to our mutual benefit. The Optimates tried and failed to take my sister by force. I would succeed by peaceable means, thereby strengthening my party's hand. 'Twould be a lie to say I would not also be glad of my sister's safe return.
A fellow plain speaker. How refreshing. Very well. Your proposal has merit, but I will need time to consider it.
Of course, my lord. May we remain in Dorma until you have come to a decision?
You shall be our honored guests. Yugiri, I leave the ambassador and his retinue in your care. See that they are well looked after.
You have our gratitude, Lord Hien. We shall look forward to your answer.